Hello everyone, in this video session I am going to explain part 21 of selenium 4, that is what's new in selenium. Before I explain what's new in selenium, let me first explain whether selenium 4 is released into the market or not. Okay, selenium 4 is officially not released into the market, guys. Okay, as per today it's November 10th 2019, and still the Selenium 4 is not officially released into the market. It is yet to be released. It looks like it's very near for Selenium 4. But guys, Selenium guys have released the alpha versions, that is, which are in the testing phase of Selenium 4 in this mvnrepository.com. If you go to this mvnrepository.com and search for the Selenium Java, you can see that Selenium guys have released this alpha versions, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. Alpha means testing phase. They are not stable, guys. Okay. So they are like for now in the testing phase. You can try it out, but you cannot actually use in your current projects until and unless Selenium guys release a stable version of Selenium 4. We cannot use in our real time or existing projects. Till then, we can only experiment or try or explore how the Selenium 4 is working and all. Okay, using this alpha versions which are in testing phase, in which few features may work, which features may not work. We may get issues and all. Okay, so something like that. So Selenium 4 is not officially released yet. It may be released by this Christmas of 2019, or maybe in the after January or something. But it's expected soon, guys. Okay, it's expected soon. A lot of people in the community are believing that it's going to be released soon because of the changes happening very fast. Okay, fine. Anyhow, I have created a list of the new changes that will be there in the Selenium 4, guys. Okay, these are the 15 points I collected, which will give you a high level idea on what exactly is going to be changed in Selenium 4 at a high level. Okay, maybe the minor things I'm not covering here, guys. There may be more. Okay, maybe this command change, that command change, a lot of things may be there in addition to whatever I have listed down here, but I'm not going to cover everything. Okay, whatever I feel important, I am covering here. Okay, it's almost a very big list, but whatever is important I am covering here, and by excluding something which is like very minor or something. Okay, fine, let's get started with what's new in Selenium 4 now. Okay, so the major highlighted change of the Selenium 4 is nothing but this W3C standardization of web driver, guys. Okay, so in Selenium 4, what is the major change if from Selenium 3 to Selenium 4 if you are traveling? Okay, in Selenium 3 we have a normal web driver, okay, and in Selenium 4 this web driver is going to be W3C standardized web driver. Okay, that's the difference. This is a major highlighted change that is going to happen in Selenium 4, guys, when compared to Selenium 3. Here we have the normal web driver, where here we have the W3C standardized web driver, worldwide web consortium standardized web driver. So because of the standardization, lot of advantages are there, guys. The web driver will become more stable, trustworthy, compatible with other softwares and browsers. Okay, this is a major thing that is going to happen. And also in the older, till Selenium 3, we have used like JSONWire protocol, but it is going to be replaced with the W3C protocol. Okay, in Selenium 4 it's going to be W3C protocol, whereas till Selenium 3 it is JSONWire protocol. Here direct communication will happen, guys. Here encoding and decoding of this API request is required in the case of JSONWire protocol. So it's kind of very smooth compared to the older protocol, guys. And this is going to be the major change in Selenium 4 when compared to Selenium 3, guys. Out of all the other changes that are listed down in this session, this one is a highlighted change. This is a major change, you can call. And okay, So I'm not going to explain in detail about this W3C standardization of web driver in this video session, guys, because I already covered about this W3C standardization of web driver in a separate video, in the one of the previous videos in the same video series. Okay, this is a part 21, guys. The previous part, I already explained in detail what is this W3C standardization of web driver, how it's going to be a major change in Selenium 4. Okay, I explained in detail, guys. You can refer to the previous video in the same video series. Okay. Now the next one, after this W3C standardization of web driver, the next new thing in Selenium 4 is the latest or new Selenium 4 IDE. Okay, the next generation IDE, you can call, is going to come. Okay, it's not going to come, guys. It's already there in the market. Like, you can actually if you try to install the Selenium IDE in the Chrome browser or Firefox browser, now you are going to get the same new latest Selenium 4 IDE, guys. Okay, it's already there in the market. Okay, it has to be officially released along with Selenium 4, but it's already there in the market, guys. If you go to the Firefox add-ons pages or Chrome browser add-on pages, you'll find that. You can try it out. So, what is the difference here? What is the change? Like, older Selenium IDE is already deprecated. In place of that, along with Selenium 4, they want to introduce Selenium 4 IDE, which anyhow it is there in the market now. Okay, even though it is not officially released. Okay, it's there in the add-ons and all. So it is like it has a new plugin system, guys. It's not similar to the older Selenium IDE. It's not same as the older Selenium IDE, guys. It's way more advanced, okay? And compared to the older Selenium IDE, okay, it can do the same thing, but it is way more advanced than the older Selenium IDE, okay? So it has a new plugin system, and it has something like Selenium IDE command line runner. Using the command line also, you can execute the tests, automated tests in Selenium IDE, okay? And I'm not going to explain all these things, guys, okay? So, because I already covered in one of the previous videos about this Selenium 4 IDE, the next generation version, okay? Just go to the previous video on this Selenium 4 IDE and try it, okay? And as I already told you, it has more advanced features, okay? When compared to the older Selenium IDE, is way far behind, guys, okay? Old Selenium IDE is way far behind. Selenium 4 has very, very good number of advanced features included to make it the next generation codeless test automation tool. Okay, Selenium guys want to make this Selenium IDE not a simple record and playback, but they want to make it a next generation codeless test automation tool. For that reason, they are adding a lot of advanced features, guys. For now, Apple Tools company is developing this Selenium 4 IDE. Okay, it's helping Selenium guys in developing the Selenium 4 IDE. So that's it about the Selenium 4 IDE, guys. If you want to find out more details about this Selenium 4 IDE, just go to the one of the previous videos in the same video series, okay? And now the next change here is improved Selenium Grid 4, okay? In the previous video, I already explained what is Selenium Grid and how to configure that as part of Selenium Grid 4, okay? There are different types of Selenium Grid now, and there is a detailed process of configuring that, which I already covered in this previous video, that is part 20 of this video series I already covered. So let's find out what exactly is changing in Selenium 4, Selenium Grid 4. Okay, first thing is that easy and smooth setup of grid, guys. Okay, earlier in Selenium Grid, in order to configure that, it takes a lot of time and it's very complex, it looks like. But now in Selenium Grid 4, they are trying to make it easy and smooth setup. Okay, they want to make the setup process very easy and smooth coming to the Selenium Grid. And in previous versions, there were like thread safety issues or bugs were there, but in Selenium Grid 4, they are trying to resolve them, okay? They want to remove these thread safety bugs by fixing them. Now here in Selenium Grid 4, they are providing basic support for using the Dock containers, okay? In order to use Selenium Grid in this Docker containers, okay? They are giving some basic support so that you can easily set up the stuff, okay? So other thing is like UI of the Selenium Grid console is to be made user friendly. So generally, if you look, Selenium Grid console will look like this. The older Selenium Grid console is like this, guys. This is a older Selenium Grid console. The UI is like bit old, like a old UI look is there here. They are trying to make this UI look rich and easy to understand also at the same time. Okay, they are working on that. Okay, so it's not available yet. They are working on this UI of the Selenium Grid console to be made more user friendly. Okay, and now as I already told, we can run the Selenium Grid 4 in three ways. That is in standalone mode, abind node modes, fully distributed modes. I already covered all this detailed configurations of the Selenium Grid in the previous video, guys. Just refer to that. I'm not going to explain everything in detail here. I'm just going to list down what's new in Selenium 4. So out of which I already covered in the previous videos, guys. This W3C standardization, new Selenium 4 IDE, improved Selenium Grid. Okay, already covered in the previous videos in detail. Okay, these are just highlights, you can say. The next thing is improved analysis. Okay, improved analysis. That means in the new Selenium 4, they are trying to make this logging and debugging details, they are trying to improve it, okay, so that we can actually resolve the script issues. For example, if when you execute some test automation script and it failed, okay, when you run some test automation script in using Selenium 4, if the particular test is failed, you are going to get more details, okay, more logging and debugging details will be there, using which you can actually analyze the issue properly, okay. You don't it will take very less time to identify what exactly is failing the test, automation test, okay. For that they are providing some logging and debugging details in the new Selenium 4. That is going to improve. The next is refresh document, okay, refresh your documentation. That means if you go to this seleniumhp.org, guys, from Selenium 2 onwards, it is the same thing, guys. They didn't update it, okay. The same old stuff is there. If you go to this documentation, the same old, you see Selenium 2.0 is there. Selenium 3.0 is not there. So what they're going to plan in this Selenium 4 is that by the time when they want to release the Selenium 4 officially, they want to make this documentation refresh. That means they will update this documentation with Selenium 4, okay. So proper documentation will be there with the updated version, okay. So we are expecting that in the official version, official website of the Selenium, that is seleniumhp.org, they are going to update the latest documentation. And next new change or a curious question that you will be having is like, existing projects won't be affected much, okay. Will the existing projects be affected or not? If Selenium 4 is released today or tomorrow, okay, and you are currently working on some Selenium 2 or Selenium 3 projects in your company, will it be very hard for migrating from Selenium 2 or 3 to the Selenium 4? Okay, so the answer here is it won't be much affected, guys, the projects, okay. Internal architecture is changing in Selenium 4. Internal architecture is changing, which will not affect your usage, guys, okay. Internally it's become, Selenium WebDriver is becoming better, but it doesn't mean that you have to do a lot of changes in order to move your Selenium 2, Selenium 3 scripts to the existing, to the Selenium 4 scripts. That's not required, guys. You can easily migrate, because most of the changes are like internal architecture changes, okay. Only few methods got deprecated. Wherever those got deprecated, you will change it, that's it. But you don't have to do much effort. You don't have to give much efforts, guys. You can easily migrate without much changes needed. Okay. So without affecting your projects, you can migrate from Selenium 2 and 3 projects to the Selenium 4, guys. Okay. Only the change is like internal architecture is changing. That is like W3C standardization and all. Almost all methods are going to be same. Only few methods, very, very, very few methods are changing, guys. They will get deprecated. In place of that, another methods will be provided. You have to use them. That's it. Okay. Apart from that, it is not going to harm your project, or it is not going to like impact your existing projects. You don't have to worry much. You can simply upgrade. Okay, that's the existing projects won't be affected much. The next new change in Selenium 4 is that the support for Opera browser and PhantomJS headless browser will be removed. Okay, as we already know that Selenium will be like supporting different browsers, right? Chrome browser, Firefox, IE, Opera, Safari, okay, Chrome, like that. All the Edge, all these browsers are supported. Out of all these browsers, supported browsers by Selenium, okay, in Selenium 4, they are stopping the support for the Opera browser, okay. As a active development for this Selenium front is not happened for this Opera browser, they are deciding to stop it, okay. They are stopping the support for Opera browser. So Opera browser active development is not happening as part of Selenium WebDriver, guys. Opera front, the active development is not happening in Selenium, guys, okay. Not in the Opera browser development, but in Selenium Opera browser support, okay, development is not happening. So they are removing the support for the Opera browser. And also there's something known as PhantomJS, which can be used for headless browser testing in Selenium test automation. Even for this also, the support is stopping. In place of the first one, that is Opera browser, we have to use Chrome browser only, okay. Instead of testing your application on Opera browser, you have to use the Chrome browser, because almost all architecture of the Chrome browser and Opera browser is same, guys, okay. So there is something known as Chromium, okay, using which the Chrome browser is like developed here in Selenium. So the same Chromium is being used by Opera. So almost they belong to the same group, guys. Okay. So since the support for the Opera browser is getting removed, in place, if you want to test something on Opera browser, you simply test on the Chrome browser. Selenium guys are suggesting you to test on the Chrome browser if your requirement is Opera, because their way of working and their way of implementation is almost same. Okay. As part of the development standards, Opera browser and Chrome browser implementations are same. So you can use the same Chrome browser for testing in Selenium automation instead of the Opera browser. Okay, fine. Coming to the next one is the PhantomJS, which is also losing its support in Selenium 4 now. But Selenium guys are suggesting to use for headless browser testing instead of using PhantomJS browser. They are suggesting to use Chrome headless browser or Firefox headless browsers. Okay, instead of performing headless browsers on using PhantomJS, they are suggesting to perform the same on the Chrome and Firefox. Okay, as part of Selenium 4, guys. Okay, fine. These are the changes. Next thing is the next new change in Selenium 4 is the element screenshots. Earlier, whenever you want to take some screenshots, what will happen, guys? The screenshot of the entire web page will be taken, right? When you take a screenshot, what will happen, guys? The screenshot of the entire web page is taken, right? But now in Selenium 4, a new feature is getting added, using which you can take the screenshot of a required element. For example, there is a button on this this page, and you want to take the screenshot of only this particular button. This is possible in Selenium 4, guys. Okay, instead of page level screenshots, you can take, okay, element level screenshots. You can take the screenshot of a text box field, button, or checkbox option, radio button, okay, anything, text area field, whatever it is, whatever the element you want to take the screenshot, you can take the screenshot in Selenium 4. Instead of taking the full screenshot of the page, you can take the screenshot of the required element in Selenium 4. So element level screenshots is possible. And I already explained this element level screenshots in a practical way, guys, in one of the previous videos of the same series. Okay, of the Selenium 4 new features series. There are many other videos before this part 21. Just go to that, guys. Go back to the previous videos. And in previous videos, I already explained how to take the element level screenshots, okay, in Selenium 4. So in a practical way, I explained it. The next new feature in Selenium 4 is the full screen mode, guys. Okay, so what is this? Till Selenium 3, we can test the applications in maximized mode only. Okay, maximized mode. Up to maximized mode, we can test, but there is no, like in Selenium 4, they're allowing you to test the applications not only in maximized mode. Here, maximized mode is there. Along with that, full screen mode also came into picture. Okay, so maximized mode is like maximizing the browser. This is like maximizing the browser. Okay, this is minimizing, this is maximizing, this is resizing, this is maximizing, guys. Now full screen is this one. Okay, if you click on this, it will become, this is the full screen, guys. Okay, you can press F11 to skip that full screen again. Okay, again it is back to the normal. This is maximized mode, and this is the, where is that, this is the full screen mode. Okay, this is a full screen mode option. So from Selenium 4, you can test, not only test the application in maximized mode, but also test in the full screen mode also. This functionality has had a newly introduced in Selenium 4, guys. So I already explained this in a practical way, guys. This full screen mode of testing the application, I already explained in a practical way in one of the previous videos of the same video series. Just go back to the previous videos and find out like how to execute the, how to actually test the application or open the application in full screen mode. Okay, refer the previous video for this, guys. The next new thing in Selenium 4 is switching to parent frame directly. Okay, till Selenium 3, we can switch from default page to parent iframe and then to child iframe. Okay, default page to parent iframe, from that to child iframe of this parent iframe. Now, if you want to go back from child to parent, it is not possible in Selenium 3, guys. Okay, in order to do that, you have to first switch from child to default, then come to parent. Okay, you have to rotate like this. In order to go back from child to parent, you cannot go like this. Is not possible. Okay, so you have to go to this default from child, and from default again you have to come to parent. If you want to move from child to parent, you have to go to default, then come to parent. This is the process in Selenium 3. But in Selenium 4, they changed it a bit where they created a shortcut where from default page, okay, to parent iframe, to child you can go, child iframe. They have given one more method using which you can now directly switch from child frame to parent frame back. Okay, the method is nothing but parent frame method, guys. Using this parent frame method in Selenium 4, you can switch back from child to parent. You don't have to go back to default and come to parent again. Rather, you can switch back immediately to the parent frame from child to parent. Okay, this is the new addition in new change in Selenium 4, guys, coming to the frames. Okay, I have already explained how to switch back to the parent frame directly from child frame in one of the previous videos of the same video series, guys. Just go back to the previous videos before part 21 and you will find it. Okay, you'll find the practical demonstration of this parent frame method, using which we can switch directly back to the parent frame from the child frame. The next new change in Selenium 4 is installing and uninstalling add-ons in Firefox browser. Okay, installing and uninstalling add-ons in Firefox browser. So if you want to install some add-on, like for example in this Firefox browser, let me open this Firefox browser. If I want to install some Selenium IDE in this browser, okay, Selenium IDE add-on I want to install in this browser. So this is the one, right? I have to go to this page and then manually click on this add to Firefox so that it will be added to this Firefox browser. But in Selenium 4, they are like using the Selenium test automation. If you want to install some add-on into the Firefox add-on or extension into the Firefox browser, you can. They have given these two extra methods, guys. Two new methods, that is install extension and uninstall extension methods, using which you can install and uninstall the add-ons in the Firefox browser using Selenium 4. I've already practically explained this how to install and uninstall add-ons in Firefox browser already, guys, in one of the previous videos of the same video series. I have practically demonstrated these options. Okay, just go there and understand. Okay, practically understand how you can install and uninstall an add-on in Firefox browser by looking at that video. Okay, one of the previous videos. Next new thing in Selenium 4 is you can open multiple tabs or windows. Okay, so like for example here, while you are automating something, let's say you have opened one application and suddenly you want to open a new tab like this. This is not possible in the Selenium 3. So in Selenium 4, they added a functionality where they added some methods where using which you can open, while you are working on this OMA application, you can open a new tab or you can open a new window like this. Okay, anything is possible. At same time, you can work on multiple applications also. For example, in one of the window, if this is a default window, let's say while you are working on this, you can open a new blank tab like this and then let's say you can open this application, new application, in another window. So simultaneously you can open multiple windows or tabs and then work on the different applications at same time, guys. Okay, this is now newly introduced in Selenium 4, guys. For that we have to use a method known as new window method. Okay, and I have already practically demonstrated, okay, I have practically demonstrated how to use this multiple tabs or windows in Selenium 4 using this new window method command. Okay, just refer to the one of the previous videos, guys, in the same video series. You'll find it out, okay, where I have practically demonstrated this stuff. The next new feature in Selenium 4 is this relative locators. Earlier they called it as friendly locators. Later they changed the name from friendly locators to relative locators. Now they are being called as relative locators. So what is new in relative locators? Till Selenium 3, if you want to locate a particular UI element in a page, you have to locate it directly. If you are not able to locate the UI element directly, there is no other way. Okay, but in Selenium 4, they introduced a new concept of relative locators. Okay, using which if you are not able to locate the UI elements directly, you can use the nearby elements to locate it. Okay, you can use the nearby some UI elements which are on the top of the required UI element, or to the left side of the required UI element, to the right side or bottom, or nearby to the required UI element, using which you can locate the UI elements. So for this, Selenium 4 has provided a good number of commands using which we can locate the UI elements instead of directly. We can locate using the nearby elements. Okay, that is nothing but relative locators. I have practically demonstrated this relative locators as part of the previous videos in the same video series, guys. Just go back to the previous video and find it out how to use this relative locators in a practical way. Fine. The next new feature in Selenium 4 is support of Chrome DevTools. Okay, so there is something like this is a Chrome browser, guys. If you inspect something or view page source or something, or press F12, you will get this Chrome browser Chrome developer tool options. Okay, so this Chrome developer tool options will have generally have Chrome Dev API. Okay, Chrome Dev API will be there for interacting with that, and they generally call that as a Chrome Dev protocol also. Okay, Chrome Dev Tools protocol will be also there for interacting with this kind of dev tools. Okay, instead of interacting this from the UI, you can use the API of this Chrome Dev to interact with this kind of options here. Okay, Chrome developer tool options. So Selenium also given the support, okay, for interacting with this game. Selenium is actually internally using the Chrome Dev Tools API for interacting with this Chrome browser developer tools. One of the feature here is in the console browser, when you refresh or something, you will get some logs here, guys. Okay, you generally get some logs here, guys. For example, I open this console, you see some logs are getting printed here. So if you want to retrieve these logs from this Chrome Dev Tools, okay, Selenium guys have some options to do that. And if you, for example, you are opening some application which has some bad certification URL, okay, when you open some application, your certificate got expired kind of messages will be displayed. You can ignore them using the certificate errors, guys. Okay, you can ignore the certificate errors using this Chrome Dev Tools API in which is implemented inside the Chrome Dev Tools class, okay, which is implemented inside the Selenium 4. And there are many other options, guys, using which you can actually play with this Chrome Dev Tools, like the network related stuff and okay, images loading stuff. A lot of things are there. And I have practically demonstrated how to use this Chrome Dev Tools class in one of the previous videos, guys. So just go back to the previous videos to find out how to use this Chrome Dev Tools class in Selenium 4 WebDriver API. Okay, fine. This is another change. It is kind of out of all this. Like this looks bit technical anyhow. But this is for like Chrome browser Dev Tools option, guys. Okay, for interacting with the Chrome Dev Tools option, you have to use this class. The next one is get size and get location methods. Okay, of web element. Got replaced by get rect method. Okay, instead of using these two methods, you can simply use this get rect method now in Selenium 4. Okay, these two methods got now replaced with a single method where you can get the height, width, and x coordinate and y coordinates using the single method. Earlier, here we used to get the height and width using the get size, and here using get location, we used to get the x coordinate and value and the y coordinate value of the given URL. But here in Selenium 4, you can use a single method, that is get rect, for getting the height and width of the element, and at same time x and y coordinate positions of the element, okay, using single method. So guys, these are the high level changes, and there may be many other changes also, maybe very technical changes, very internal changes may be there. Okay, I don't want to explain everything here, but whatever I feel important that you have to know as part of changes in Selenium 3 and Selenium 4, I have covered everything. Okay, and one more note before I conclude this session is that till now Selenium 4 is in alpha state only, that is alpha 1, alpha 3, alpha 2, alpha 3, and they may release few more alpha versions also before releasing the stable version. We don't know about that, but as part of the other alpha versions also, they may actually introduce other few new features of Selenium 4 also. Okay, till alpha 3, whatever the new features I found, I documented here. As you can see, these are all the things that are observable as part of the current alpha versions of Selenium 4. Tomorrow, if they release any other new alpha versions, they may have more features also. Okay, so for now, the current state, this is the thing, guys. These are the new changes in Selenium 4. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.